I got a request today to make a management video about Teams rooms. So let's start with the most basic Teams rooms management video ever. And that is, let's talk about how to manage Teams rooms out of the box. And the reason it's so easy to manage this thing out of the box is because you don't have to do anything. The video could end now. Don't do anything, the thing will take care of itself. But you're probably watching these videos because you're like, let's see what all that really means. So if you didn't know, Teams Rooms reboots every night at 2 a.m. And we can look at that by going to Task Scheduler. So let's open up Task Scheduler, go to Microsoft, then Skype. And we've got this nightly reboot job, which takes off at 2 a.m. every day. And it runs for about a half hour, and then it reboots your machine. And this runs every day. So 2:01 a.m. every day, your local time. So I'm in Florida in the U.S. So 2:01 a.m. my time, it takes off. If you're in Melbourne, Australia, at 2:01 your local time, this will reboot. So nobody should be on. If you have routine meetings during this time, which is rare, you can edit this to start earlier or later, but really let it run every day because this does a lot of things, this script. Some of it we'll get into in a later security discussion, but for basic management, what this really does is check for Windows updates and Microsoft Store updates. So if we were to look at this machine, and trust me, I didn't force any Windows updates to make it look good. I actually checked it just briefly to see what story I was gonna have to tell. Here's Windows updates, I'm up to date. Last checked at 4:38 a.m. So this is after the reboot, the machine went out at 4:38 a.m. and said, hey, there are no Windows updates. You know why? Because at 2:01 a.m., a script ran to install any updates, and then at about 2:30 a.m., the device reboots to apply any updates. So that's how Windows updates happen. That's hands-free. This comes out of the box. There's nothing you need to do. So if we look at the Microsoft Store, this is where the Teams Rooms app gets installed, and it's really called Skype Rooms System by name, by the name of the store app. So it says modified today. I'm not sure what happened. That happened overnight. So let's check for get updates. Good to go. No updates need to happen. Now we're focused on this. Sometimes you come in here and like mail and calendar needs an update or Microsoft Photos. I don't care about those. Nobody cares about those because we aren't using those on a Teams Rooms system. But this should always show up to date. If not, it'll be because you haven't rebooted. Like you saw it at 2 p.m. or 1400 your time and it just got downloaded earlier that day. And so that night during the reboot, it will reinstall. Okay, so that's how we update Windows and Microsoft Store. We the admin, do nothing. What about like antivirus? We have to put antivirus and stuff in here. Oh, there's Windows Defender, Windows Security. It's got an alarm. Well, first off, let's skip that alarm for now, and let's look at all these other ones. Green, 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 green. So the Windows definitions, the Windows Firewall, Windows Defender, antivirus, anti-malware definitions, those get installed every night too. So we're up to date on our antivirus signatures. Now this is saying set up OneDrive for file recovery options. No end user ever copies files to a Teams Rooms device. Only a system admin can. And system admins, the only files they should be copying onto a device are firmwares. And maybe some log files if they're working with support, but that's it. We don't need to back up important data on Teams Rooms. So we don't need to set up OneDrive. So we're all green. So what did I do to set this up? Nothing. I turned the machine on, I let Teams Rooms do its thing. We've got Windows Firewall, all this stuff is set up, all the ports are there. Now we're starting to veer off into a security discussion with firewall and antivirus, but this is all done. So for basic management, there's nothing you need to do. Just turn it on. And actually, kind of my mantra is the less you do, the better this device is going to perform. Because like with Windows Defender, we've tested the Teams Rooms app and all of the peripherals and all of the configurations with this antivirus software and this anti-malware and this security software. We haven't tested with every possibility out there. So the only thing you could do is potentially add instability without adding any tangible security benefit. Anyway, I'm starting to ramble. That is the basics of Teams Rooms management, and that is, it's super basic. You don't need to do anything.